Hello, and welcome to Let's Play Mega Man X. I'm Hawkeye, and man, this is a change from the last game. This is my childhood here, folks. This is one of the best games I've ever played in my life. When I was younger, and I was actually playing this on an old CRT TV, which was, you know, all we had back then. You kids with your plasma monitors and your rock and roll music. I played the wheels off of this thing. I mean, I played this game so often that, back in the days when the internet was just a fledgling thing and we used services like AOL or CompuServe instead. And if you don't know what those are, go ask your parents. I actually wrote a walkthrough for this game from memory, because I played this game so often. And I decided that I was going to do this for my next Let's Play, because, well, basically everybody seems to like this game. When I announced that I had plans to do it, I got a generally very positive reception. So, enjoy! The only caveat is I probably won't be failing as much on this game as when I was playing Doom 3. Famous last words, you can write that on my tombstone, folks. One thing I noticed recently that I don't know if I ever noticed this when I was younger, was, these B-copter things, when you shoot them, you know, instead of having what you would call a traditional life meter, the more damage you do to it, the further to the left it moves until it falls. And I didn't really realize the mechanic, that was the mechanic it used until, relatively recently. Or it could be I realized that when I was younger and I just forgot entirely. Either one is just as accurate, to be perfectly honest. Sorry for the stuttering, folks. Hopefully that'll clear itself up. And this one's Fernanda. Riding on cars! This large airship is going to start dropping some more cars on me. And another thing I realized is that you have to make sure to really go after them. You have to destroy them entirely. If the broken husks drive off the screen, it doesn't count as destroying one. And you have to destroy two in order to make our little Boba Fett wannabe here drop down. Now, this guy is invincible. You can't beat him. He has plot armor, quite literally. You worthless piece of scrap metal, did you think you could defeat me?
Maybe.
Ah. Our savior arrives. For those of you who don't know, our savior in red here is Zero. I guess I'm not powerful enough to defeat him. I haven't gotten any of my power-ups yet. X, you shouldn't expect to defeat him. He's designed to be a war machine. Remember, you've not reached full power yet. If you use all the abilities you were designed with, you should become stronger. You may even become as powerful as I am. No false modesty here, folks. I'll scout ahead and collect as much information on Sigma's fortress as I can. I'll meet up with you when you get there. See you later. X, I know you can do it. Ah, yes. For some of you, younger individuals out there, this is called a password screen. Yeah, we didn't have memory cards back in the day. We had to actually write down codes to save our progress. This, for anyone who has ever played a Mega Man game before, you will instantly recognize as the boss select screen. This was really cool back in the day because they threw in little extras here. They'd show you what the stage looked like, the specs of the bosses, and where they are on a larger map. You can see where they fit into the big picture. Now, the first boss I'm going to tackle is this guy here. Chill Penguin. And there is a very good reason for me to tackle this stage first, and you'll see why shortly. Yeah, I'm not particularly concerned with self-preservation, so I'm not gonna be going out of my way to avoid getting hit. That is something that has served me better than you might think. Especially in a game like this where, life energy power-ups are relatively frequent. Now, the stage really familiarizes you with how the stages are built to work against you. Like, you have these little spiky rolly guys who roll down these inclined platforms. Ah, and here is the reason we're here. Dr. Thomas Light, so you've come. X, I gave you the ability to choose your own path in life. And I'd hoped that the world would allow you to choose a peaceful one. But now, it seems that you are destined to fight. Because I thought the world might need a new champion, I have hidden capsules like this one. If you find and use them, you will be able to increase your powers beyond anything the world has ever known. Step into this capsule and receive an acceleration system to boost your speed. Good luck, X. Yeah, these capsules give us upgrades to our armor. There are 4 normal capsules like this, and 1 special one that we'll get to when the time comes. So this is the Emergency Acceleration Booster. It allows us to dash. Wow, I almost died there, because I'm pretty sure I was invincible. And by invincible, I actually made invisible. Those are 2 different words, Bob. Yep, this is the only upgrade you don't have to find in a hidden location. In fact, there is literally no way to avoid it. I've actually tried. This is a suit of powered armor, much like we saw Vile using. That was the Boba Fett wannabe. It's not quite as powerful as his. He has a custom-made suit. Our suit can't take quite as much punishment. It will actually be destroyed after a few shots. You would think that robots designed to throw snowballs would not be particularly dangerous, but you would be a fool. That's useful. However, I'm not going to delude myself into thinking that my chances of beating the boss with half health are terribly high. In fact, I've always had what you might call a tradition in that I never take a boss fight particularly seriously in a Mega Man game until after I've died once, so that I have full health. But that doesn't mean I'm going to make it easy for him. Well, that's a thing. That is really unusual for me. Alright, that's one stage down. We got 7 Mavericks to go. I almost said Robot Masters. That's not exactly accurate for the X series. We get Shotgun Ice. This is a very useful weapon against Spark Mandrill. Another interesting thing to note about Mega Man X is that beating certain bosses will actually have effects on the environments of other stages. Like, for example, I believe beating Chill Penguin makes it so that the lava in this guy's stage is frozen over. But we're not going to this guy's stage next. Are going to go here next time on Let's Play Mega Man X Spark Mandrill. I've been Hawkeye. Thanks for watching. Ad Astra.